everyone, James Baek here, and it's time for some more Those Battle Spot from Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. Today, we will be using a team of Landers, Varian, Thunders Varian, Charizard, Scizor, Hydreigon, and Terrakion. Now, this team, I did do a little thinking on like the last team I did, and it's just basically overwhelm my opponents with super heavy offense, with Landers, Varian having a base attack stat of 145, Thunderous Varian getting a special attack of base 145. Charizard Y has the same special attack stat, base 145 when Mega Charizard Y, and it also gets the Drought ability, which increases its fire type moves even further. Anyway, let's begin. We find someone from Japan, 1719 rating. Let's see how this is gonna turn out. We're gonna see the team of Latias, Lucario, Togekiss, Greninja, Blissey, and Rhyperior. So he has two possible Megas in the Latias and the Lucario, which are both viable without Mega, so it's going to be hard to tell which one. I'm guessing probably Mega Lucario, since he has Togekiss with Follow Me support. I also have to worry about fast attacks for the Greninja. And, let's see what I'm gonna do. It looks like Scizor's gonna be very useful in this situation. I think leading Scizor is a must. And I don't want to lead with Hydreigon. The only problem with leading with Hydreigon is the Togekiss, who can follow me, Draco Meteor. I'm choice locked into Draco Meteor, and it doesn't do much. So I'm thinking of leading Scizor and Terrakion, actually, with Charizard. And it's either Hydreigon or Thunderous in the back. Then again, I could bring Landers as well. They're all pretty good options. I think I'm going to bring the Thunderous, because it does have Grass Knot to take care of the Rhyperior quickly, and Thunderbolt for the Togekiss. This is a very hard decision, but I think I'm going to go with Thunderous. Let's see how it plays out, because it was really hard to decide between Landorus, Thunderous, and Hydreigon. They all have pretty good options, but I thought Thunderous might actually help me more. So let's see what he is gonna lead with, or she, it could be a she. Togekiss and Blissey. Okay, that is an interesting combination. I'm guessing Follow Me Minimize will be a thing. So I'm gonna set up a Swords Dance with Scizor, and I'm gonna substitute with my Terrakion. I really don't think this lead has much offensive pressure. Togekiss is gonna go for the Follow Me. Terrakion's gonna get a free substitute up. Scizor's gonna get its Swords Dance up, which is very good, as I'm a plus 2 Scizor, and Blissey is gonna go for Minimize, so I'm not gonna be having fun. So, I'm not sure Bullet Punch will KO the Togekiss depending on the investment, so I think I'm gonna Bullet Punch and Rock Slide, just so I'm guaranteed to KO the Togekiss. Bullet Punch is gonna connect with the Togekiss, which it barely knocks it out, and it's carrying Rocky Helmet. Terrakion's gonna go for the Rock Slide, hitting both Pokemon. It should do a lot to Blissey, since Blissey has a base 5 defense, but it does have a massive HP stat. As Togekiss is gonna faint, Blissey reveals the Key Berry, and now we might actually have some trouble. Terrakion gonna take some Life Orb damage, but Blissey does flinch, so that means if he went for Minimize, it's not gonna happen. He's gonna send out Greninja as his next Pokemon, and I'm okay with that. I can freely Bullet Punch and Rock Slide again, just for some damage. Bullet Punch is gonna happen onto the Greninja. It's gonna do over half thanks to plus 2. Greninja revealing the Surf. As Blissey avoids the attack, it's gonna hit both my Pokemon. It's gonna break Terrakion's sub, do a nice damage to Scizor. As Terrakion's gonna get a Rock Slide, which Blissey avoids the attack, but Rock Slide should finish off the Greninja, and now I'm at a 4-2 lead, but his Blissey's probably going to go for Minimize, and it's going to be really annoying to attack, as it does go for the Minimize, and now it's a plus 4 evasion. Yeah, this is going to not be fun. Playing this kind of game is very annoying, especially with a long timer. In VGC, you only get a timer of 15 minutes, since VGC 14, and that really just made strategies like minimize not viable, but on Battle Spot doubles, you have double the time, so it's actually kind of viable, and people will do this to win. So he sends out Latios. I'm going to protect Terrakion because I'm going to need it to one-hit KO the Blissey. And going to Bug Bite the Latios, which is Mega. It's Mega Latios. As Terrakion's going to go for Protect, let's see if this Latios has Hidden Power Fire. As it goes for Psych Up onto the Blissey. No! That's plus 4. Oh, but I connect with the Mega Latios. It is going down. Critical hit even. A plus 2 critical hit Bug Bite. And now his Blissey's plus 6 evasion. But it looks pretty good here. As long as I can get one more attack off, I should be good. I'm going to Swords Dance with my Scizor and Close Combat the Blissey slot. Hopefully I can come back with this. Terrakion goes for a Close Combat. It does hit, and I will be taking this game 4-0. Scizor and Terrakion proving how strong they are. And Minimize, you're not a viable strategy anymore. So I will take this win. I didn't get to use my other Pokemon, but hopefully I'll be able to use this team again, as it was very... I didn't get to show off any of the real power it had other than Scizor and Terrakion, even though they were just Pokemon I put on the side based on my core of Charizard Y, Thunderous, Landorus, and Hydreigon. So be sure to like, comment, subscribe, share with your friends. Follow me on Twitch because I do stream Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. I do take viewer battles. I do stream Battle Spot sometimes. And when VGC 15 rules come out, there will be a whole lot of streaming for practice and stuff. So be sure to check that out. Be sure to follow me on Twitter. Know when new videos are coming up. And I'll see you guys next time.